Hey, Stephen Smith here, and I believe that I have a word from the Lord for you today. You know, that's exactly what it is today. I believe that the word of the Lord is for us today and that it will actually go out and make a difference in your life as you get to know it and as you get to study it more. That's the whole process of what God has been showing us over the last 2 days. In fact, yesterday he talked about his spoken word, and today he revealed to me that he wants us to get into and to look at his written word. So what a blessing that is for us. So the obvious scripture has to be Joshua 1:8, right? So this is what it says. Study this book of instruction continually. Meditate on it day and night, so you will be sure to obey everything written in it. Only then will you prosper and succeed in all that you do. Can you imagine that our success actually is tied into how much time we spend in the Word of God? It's not a tit for tat, but it is rather get into the instructions that I provided for you, use them to your benefit, and do things the way that I have shown you to do them, and you'll be successful. I mean, this is a perfect promise that we can see from God that enables us to be able to do that. David follows up on this in Psalms 1:2-3. He says, But his delight is in the law of the Lord, and in his law he meditates day and night. He shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water that brings forth its fruit in season, whose leaf also shall not wither, and whatever he does shall prosper. Again, this is talking about us delighting in the law of the Lord, that we meditate on it. The Message translation says that we chew on it day and night. If we can do these things, then we can understand that God's word should take the primary place in our lives to give us direction, purpose, and meaning to our lives. If we can do that, if we can succeed in that, then everything else that we touch, everything else that we do will be word-based, will be based on what God has done, and God will actually be involved in everything that we're doing. When we invite him in, then there's absolutely nothing that we can't do. And in fact, the path that we should go on will be always illuminated for us. Psalms 119:105, right? Your word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. God's written word, God's commandments are all here for us to be able to grow, to be able to learn, to be able to grow in him. So let's take those things and make a difference in us. You know, Jesus responded to Satan when Satan was trying to get him to take his focus off of the word of God. This is what Jesus said. This is Matthew 4:4. But Jesus told him, no, the scriptures say people do not live by bread alone, but by every word that comes from the mouth of God. Imagine that. Every word that God has spoken is something that we can live in, something that we can elaborate on, something that we can tap into, and our success will actually arise from there. You know, the blessings that we have are all blessed, are blessings that God has given to us, blessings that we can receive, but we don't know about them until we open up the written word of God. Look at what Jesus says in Luke 11:28. It says, but Jesus replied, but even more blessed are all who hear the word of God and put it into practice. So if I hear the word of God, if I have it written down for me, and if I'm starting to meditate on it, and then I start doing what it says, then there's no way that I cannot be blessed. You know, God's given us all these things so that we can grow in him and so that we can get to know him even better. If we look at it this way, God's word is really a love letter from him to us. And it's not just instructions. It's about how much he loves us and how much he wants us to succeed. So he gives us these instructions. Well, this is the word that I believe that the Lord gave to me for us today. I've given you my word. Read it, study it, learn it. It will always show you the pathway to your success. Let my words be the first to come from your mouth and you will find that your life will go well. Well, I hope that this post has been a blessing to you and that your life will change because of the Word of God and as you study it and get to know him even better. Why not share this on Facebook or go to YouTube and see some of the other messages that have been posted there. You're also more than welcome to go to our webpage at awfg.today and see all the different things that we have there. We even have a blog posted there where you can actually see the transcripts of what we talked about today. Well, God bless you, and I hope to hear from you soon.